ABC One.
Now on BBC Two, highlights of the first day's play in the fifth test, introduced by Richie Beno.
England squared the series at Old Trafford, and they come to Trent Bridge 2-2 in this six test match series. A tremendous performance up there, and a very heartening one for Michael Atherton and his men. Not quite so for Richie Richardson, who had more problems at Trent Bridge this morning. First of all, there was Carl Hooper. The opening batsman is out with a finger injury that hampered him at Old Trafford. Then there's Jimmy Adams, struck in the head by a bouncer in the match following the Old Trafford game. He's out of the side. And Junior Murray, although he looked to have lost form in the last test match, is said to be suffering from an injury and is unavailable to play. And that great fast bowler, Curtly Ambrose, is also out of the side. Muscle spasms this morning, and he can't take his place in the final 11. In comes Stuart Williams, who made 100 after the Old Trafford test match. And that very good left-hander, Shivnarine Chanderpaul, only a young player, but comes with a big reputation. He hit 100 off the Somerset attack straight after that Old Trafford loss. As wicketkeeper, we have Courtney Brown. It's his second cap for the West Indies. Takes the place of Junior Murray, and he also took Junior Murray's place in the recent test match against the Australians in Jamaica. You don't see too many leg spinners in West Indian test match teams, but here's Rajendra Dhanraj, who is a very talented bowler. I've seen him bowl only on television. Looks to me as though he has a bit about him. Welcome to the highlights of the opening day of this Cornhill Test match at Trent Bridge. We've had four good matches so far, two of them very exciting at Lord's and at Old Trafford. And the England side is confirmed here. This is the way it looks. Michael Atherton, Nick Knight, John Crawley, Graham Thorpe, Graham Hick, then White, Russell, Watkinson, Cork, Illingworth and Fraser. Recalls there for both Hick and Illingworth. And the West Indies, we've noted their injury problems. They have many changes there. Williams, Campbell, Lara, Richardson, Atherton, Chanderpaul, Courtney Brown, Bishop, Benjamin, Walsh and Dhanraj. And the two captains, Michael Atherton and Richie Richardson, went out to the centre for the toss, and then they talked with Tony Lewis.
Morning, Mike. You've won the toss, and what's the decision?
Well, we'll bat. It looks a pretty good deck, and hope to try and get some runs on the board.
And how have you settled your side?
We've left Mark Aylott and Alan Wells out there, 13.
How's your back?
It's all right. Get twinges every now and again, but I'm holding up.
Did I read that you were jumping around in pads?
No, it's not me. Too strenuous for me.
Well, no problems there for Michael Atherton, deciding to bat on what looks to be a very, very good pitch, an absolute belter, and on an extremely fast outfield. Here's Geoffrey Boycott now to tell us a little more about the strip on which the two teams will perform.
Well, this is Ron the groundsman's last test match pitch. He's retiring and he's created an absolute beauty, one of the best I've seen here. It's very dry and straw-coloured. You can't see any green grass. There's no dampness in it. You can see already the cracks appearing, just to show you how dry it is. It's very firm, quite hard. If we go down here on a seam bowler's length, you look here, it's beautiful. There isn't a blade of grass out of place, no greenness, no dampness, nothing patchy, nice root growth. It's an absolute batsman's dream. It should be medium pace, not too quick, and there should be no reason for complaint by any player on either side on this surface.
Doesn't sound as though there'd be any problems there for either Michael Atherton or Richie Richardson. Just confirming that England won the toss and batting, and Nigel Clews and Cyril Mitchley are the umpires. Standing here, third umpire is George Sharp. We join play now with the first ball of the second over. Ian Bishop is the bowler. Michael Atherton, the England skipper, is taking strike. No wickets down and no runs on the board.
Well, that's the first test for Courtney Brown, very wide down the leg side.
signalled as four byes by Cyril Mitchley. Very wild delivery. And Courtney Brown, keeping for the first time in this series, saw it move further and further away. He's a tall man, Courtney Brown, couldn't reach it. And the first run's off the bat. Mike Atherton just guiding that all the way down to third man.
Yes, he just relaxed the hands here, played it sort of semi-defensive, let it run off the face. Wasn't totally sure where it was going, but he was in control. He knew it was going on the floor. Well, that was a dreadful shot. It just came out of nowhere. Nick Knight played nice and safe and sound until suddenly has a rush of blood. I think that will have encouraged Courtney Walsh, that sort of shot.
A gentle chase round the boundary for Ian Bishop. Two more runs. Big appeal. That was the slower ball again from Courtney Walsh. That's the way that Nick Knight was out in the first innings at Old Trafford. The slower ball deceived him. He's managed to get a bat on that one. That'll be four. Just played really with the swing by Mike Atherton. Nothing more than a guided shot. Nicely timed, let the ball come to him and just helped it on its way. Nice comfortable start so far for England.
Between the slips, Chanderpaul and Williams, the two men at second and third slip. They're having a little discussion now as to how it got through, whether or not it was anyone's fault, could they have done better? And the answer probably is yes.
I think the disappointing thing from the West Indies point of view is that that was a genuine edge and it still didn't carry to second or third slip.
Courtney Walsh changes the line here and then there's some hesitation from the batsman. Shivnarine Chanderpaul quickly onto that, but of course the batsmen have already cleared the single.
Beautifully bowled. A lovely outswinger, which to the left-hander was an in-swinger, and then it kept moving after it hit the seam.
This is exactly what he is well known for, Kenny Benjamin. He does move the ball a lot. Surprising, though, that he started on a very short run.
Five runs in an hour for Nick Knight. The importance for England is not to have the partnership broken. We're all aware they're on a good batting pitch and it's been a good toss to win. Knight's had the bulk of the strike as well, 51 balls to 36 for Atherton.
Oh, that's well bowled and well played. And as I described the batsman's dilemma, I see not a flicker of sympathy at all in the eye of Colin Croft.
Well, this is the first ball that's actually done this. It was just short of a good length, so it would not be considered a short ball, but it bounced a little bit more than perhaps even Courtney Walsh expected. Mike Atherton played it well. In the end, just dropping his hand and allowing the ball to bounce off the bat and not really carry. But that was well bowled by Courtney Walsh.
there's a man down there. That was aimed much squarer than that. This is Kenny Benjamin's third over. And he's bowled two maidens so far. And what's been impressive is not only the line, but also the length he's bowled. And a big shout there for LBW.
First genuine shout this morning for an LBW, perhaps too high and might have even beat leg stump. It's worth a shout, especially under these conditions where one wicket is going to be very vital.
So a positive move here by Richie Richardson. Dan Raj from Trinidad. The prospect he faces is not of whipping out the whole England batting order, but having a long bowl, I hope, and just winkling a couple of wickets out, and that would be a proper contribution to the West Indies efforts. And I took a walk along the River Trent this morning, all sorts of bird life. There you see the swans, and, but it was the heron waiting for breakfast which intrigued me most. Rajendra Danraj. Easy, comfortable shot. Straight out of the textbook.
Yes, I just feel with Nick Knight that something's got to happen in his batting at the moment. He needs a slice of luck, maybe an inside edge that goes for four or anything, just to get his score moving. He's stuck a bit.
Well, no doubt about that. Had plenty of time just to pick his spot. It's a slow pitch here at Trent Bridge today, and if Danraj is going to drop short... then Mike Atherton is going to take full advantage. Lovely shot from Mike Atherton. Pure class. Just timed away and hit dead straight down the ground. Takes Mike Atherton on to 36 and England on to 50.
Well, there's just no margin for error for any bowler, particularly the spinner who bowls it much slower than the seamers. I think... got to set a field and try and get the batsman driving through the offside.
Hooked up and safely.
Well, attempted a bouncer off a short runner, but you're going to have to bowl a lot quicker than that if you're going to bounce anybody on this pitch. I mean, Michael Atherton didn't have to get in a perfect position to hit that well. There's no real pace or bounce in this pitch, and to really surprise a batsman, you're going to have to put some work into it.
Ooh, a slice of luck there for Mike Atherton. Picks up four runs for it. But Kenny Benjamin looked to beat him for pace.
Yes, we said through the series that Kenny Benjamin has the ability to kind of skid it onto batsmen and just surprise you a little bit. No great bounce in that, was there? He was only going to clip top of off stump, maybe. If Michael hadn't inside edged it, it's just that it skidded onto Michael a little bit quicker.
Beautifully played, just used his feet. Made what little ground he needed, hit it on the full toss and found the gap perfectly.
It skidded onto Michael a little bit quicker.
Beautifully played, just used his feet. Made what little ground he needed, hit it on the full toss and found the gap perfectly. The first boundary for Nick Knight today.
Yes, it was a nice shot as well. He just used his feet. I think there'll be a nice sense of relief in the England dressing room. Played quite nicely defensively. But the players will be aware as well, his teammates, that he just needed a run or two.
Definitely worth a shout. It did turn just a little. By the time it got up to the stumps, it may well have missed. But definitely worth a yell.
It's interesting, I think, that the wicketkeeper started appealing before it had actually hit the pad. And it take a little bit of guile from him to get the batsman out. Mike Addison, in the meantime, looking quite organized, very relaxed, just pitched outside leg stump and just at the turn. I think this is the problem with the leg spin bowler. He bowls perhaps three or four good balls and then one ball that gives the batsman a little bit of leeway. Immediately he would punk.
Second bounce.
This Atherton, I think, missed field. I think he recognized he's made a mistake. The ball does turn away on a second bounce. Wright smiles from him when it passed him.
Four taken from that over. Didn't deserve that to happen. Ball from right hand to left. And he takes his right arm side, gets into a nice smooth action. That over, and that might have been the over spinner. Is that slow ball again? And it certainly defeated Nick Knight.
Well, this guy is slow ball by Courtney Walsh. Shout. If anything, I think might just have been beating leg stump.
Batsman's heart would have leapt there for a fraction of a second, and certainly so would the bowler's. Got the inside edge onto that. Well, he might have been saved by the off stump as well and playing a stroke, but it was a very good delivery. That's a cracking stroke from a slightly over-pitched delivery from Courtney Walsh. Doesn't provide too many of those.
The 100 comes up. One tonight, 100 for England without loss, Knight 29 and Atherton 66.
Mike Atherton, since he's been captain, he's done everything really that could be asked of him to set the right example. That's beaten everyone. Racing away to the boundary. That's got away behind square on the offside. Vanderpool giving chase, but to no avail. It's going to be a long wait for Graham Thorpe. listed to come in at four.
Very welcome. Next night now. On 244. Yep. He didn't pick it, but got it away for at least two. Three runs for the night, three fielders for the Windies. Still counts. So the one he didn't pick, it's just gone away, just meant to be the wrong one. Might have turned a fraction. And Richie Richardson, two others doing the chasing. After four. So in the last couple of overs he's unleashed two very good boundaries to take him to his half century. His first one in Test cricket. First time he hit Arthur away over mid wicket. And then off the front foot he's crashed Benjamin away to take him to 51.
Fine shots. Straightforward enough in, as a full toss from Dan Raj, but nevertheless, nicely timed away.
The day's been that sort of day. It's just gone along. It's very hot. There's been nothing great happening in the cricket. Just England have gone along steadily.
That's got him. Surely that's got him. McKnight leaving the ball alone. And the judged LBW to the bowling of Ken wicket falls at 148. And Nick Knight's careful vigil ended on 57.
Well, I was saying this afternoon that I felt on this pitch it would have to be a miscalculation by the batsman. I couldn't see the bowlers making the ball do anything unusual, and that's as plumb as you'll get on the back foot. It's total miscalculation, just let it go. Getting somewhere around middle and off. Nice steady innings, giving England a very, very good platform. But I think in some ways, I don't think they'll be that unhappy that he's done a good job, that he's actually out. I think England will probably want to get the scoreboard just ticking over a little bit more. New batsman is John Crawley.
That's found plenty of space at the wicket. Carbon copy of a shot that Mike Allison played this morning when Dan Raj dropped short. This pitch is slow, slow enough that really once the ball is short from the slow bowlers, the batsman can just place it where he would. That's a good shot. Nice piece of work too. Right out on the edge of the field there from Brian Lara. Fine shot. Rose to that challenge. Could have been a passing wasp. Could have been a passing cricket ball.
Yes, I like this shot. He was into it very quick, was John Crawley. There was nothing half-hearted about it. He was expecting one eventually, and when it came, he was really going to go after it.
Well, he's found the gap at mid-wicket. Enough to get him two more. Two balls left in the over, and I'm sure Mike Atherton will be very happy just to add this extra run within those two balls. Oh, so close. Close to the hundreds, close to a nasty little nick as well.
An extraordinary shot, really, though, on 99. He's already had 199 in his career. And this sort of pitch is made for him to get 200 if he wants.
That's a great shot. Right on top of that one, John Crawley. Really just punched it through that offside.
Well, I think this is as good a shot as we've seen today. It's from a batsman who's just come in, remember. So he hasn't had the opportunity to get the pace of the pitch or get used to anything. That was a gorgeous shot.
That'll do nicely. Just had to scurry at the end, but that's Michael Atherton's 100.
Him. Brilliant catch. Superb catch at first slip. John Crawley goes for 14. Stuart Williams, the catcher. Kenny Benjamin enjoying success. 179 for two.
Kenny Benjamin is known as a wicket taker, and here he's bowling just maybe short of a good length, a little bit more bounce than Crawley wanted. And coming off a genuine edge, Stuart Williams moving nicely to his right, taking it where I suppose second slip would have been.
Herb Thorpe is the incoming batsman. So that's a very good catch, and the second wicket down, 179 for two wickets.
Ian Bishop, I think, having a change of boots. This is the second time he's had this happen today. Hot conditions, so you need to be comfortable.
Edged away, very fine. Ian Bishop's got his boots on now, but won't be able to catch it. And neither was Stuart Williams able to launch himself from first slip. Genuine edge from Mike Atherton. Well, he's got the new boots. If he runs out of hats, that's where to get a new one from. All stock must be cleared before the end of the test match. Ah, oh, beautiful times. That really was a sweet shot.
But this is just excellent timing, just short of a good length, outside off stump, and Mike Atherton immediately onto the back foot and just timing it off the middle of the bat, sweetly.
That's a fine shot. Ian Bishop has not really loosened up for this spell yet. That one didn't swing. And Graham Thorpe happy just to thump it down the ground. That's a lovely shot. You don't see many better shots than that for timing, placement. Many a coach in the country will be applauding that shot for the straightness of the hit. and the ease of the shot. That boundary also bringing up the 200. It's taken England 328 minutes, the best part of 5.5 hours.
That's tight. That is very tight. That's brilliant work by the fielder at mid-on. And Atherton wasn't expecting it. The fielder had to run on an angle, and Atherton, well, if not loping, wasn't giving it everything in the big ones. Well, Atherton has a problem. Another England wicket goes down. Atherton run out at Old Trafford, and now run out again at Trent Bridge at Old Trafford when the team was chasing runs. And here, after he'd made 113. That's a great ovation for Michael Atherton. Well deserved, too. He's batted right through from the start of play until 5.35. And the night watchman comes in now, Richard Illingworth. Still with eight overs to play today on a beautiful batting pitch and in the most perfect conditions imaginable. 206 for three. Always difficult when the main batsman in the pair has a night watchman in with him. Too many more of those, and we'll have Angus Fraser out there.
Beauty. He's got him. Well bowled. He's got him. Yeah. Must have been a very, very faint nick. Graham Thorpe waiting for the umpire's decision. That was beautifully bowled by Ian Bishop. Lovely line and length. He's been aiming it round about middle and off. Just got it to leave the left-hander. And that's great delight for Ian Bishop. He thoroughly earned that by a good line. He's been bowling at Graham Thorpe.
Now then, we have a problem. Who comes out now? I would think it would have to be the original batsman, Graham Hick.
Well, that's quite right, Richie. You can't have two night watchmen in on such a benign, easy pitch.
Great stroke. Been passed in the outside edge half a dozen times out there, and that was a good one. One more run added to take the total at the end of the day up to 227 for four. Michael Atherton 113, Nick Knight 57, that was a good opening stand of 148. Then John Crawley 14, Graham Thorpe 19, the West Indies fought back there, and Richard Illingworth, the night watchman, unbeaten on eight at the end. And Graham Hick on six. 10 extras, 227 for four. And the West Indies, they stuck to it very well, I thought. Did a good job today. England could have got away and made something around about the 300 mark on that pitch and in these conditions. Walsh none for 61. The wicket takers, Bishop one for 41 and Benjamin two for 36. Danrose 77 from 24 overs and Atherton eight from four overs. So both sides would be reasonably pleased. Michael Atherton should be pleased that England have done as well as they have, and West Indies that they fought back so well. And after play, I talked with the England captain, Michael Atherton. Michael, well played. That was a good performance.
Yeah, I was pleased to get 100, and I haven't had one for a while, but I was disappointed to be run out because I was looking to get a big score, really.
You were run out at Old Trafford as well, but you don't actually make a habit of it.
I try not to. Geoffrey Boycott keeps giving me plenty of ribbing. He says I'm catching him up on the number of run-outs, but it's only the third time in my test career, I think.
You've got a long way to go. What about the pitch out there?
Oh, it's a good pitch. Very flat. Good pitch for batting, and, you know, we hope we can make full use of it tomorrow.
Nick Knight?
I thought he did really well. It's only his second test match, and he found it hard work at the start, but he stuck in. That was the great thing. He showed plenty of character, and the runs flowed a bit more freely after lunch, and I was pleased that he got 50.
Everyone's interested in the new players who come in. He looked pretty good up at Old Trafford under extreme pressure. Not quite so much pressure here today.
I think he hasn't looked fazed by the occasion. You stand at the other end and you watch a young player play his first game, and you can tell whether somebody's overawed by the occasion. I don't think he has been. He's caught his catches and he's got stuck in with a bat.
Graham Thorpe?
He's disappointed he got out at the end there, because he's a big player for us. I said before the game, really, myself, Thorpe and Hickey are the three with experience and caps under our belt, and we're the ones who've got to show the rest of the way.
It's a long time since you've had a West Indian attack against you with the three pace bowlers and a leg spinner.
Yeah, when he came on in the first hour almost, I couldn't remember the last time I faced any spin from the West Indies. I think it was in the back end of the tour 2 years ago, but it was a nice change.
What did you think of it?
Obviously, it's difficult for him today because the pitch was very flat. There was no real pace or bounce for him. But I didn't think he did a bad job for Richie Richardson. Obviously, he had to keep his pace bowlers fresh, and I thought that Dan Raj did that for him.
What about the overall position?
We had a poor last session, lost four wickets, but I think we'll probably settle for that at the beginning of the day. Much depends on how we can crack on tomorrow.
Looked to me as though Ian Bishop was swinging the ball late in the day. Was that some form of reverse swing, do you think?
I'm not so sure. The ball didn't look scuffed. I don't think the wicket was conducive to scuffing the ball, so maybe they just got a good shine on it, a good polish on it.
Chance for Watkinson and Illingworth with the ball?
We hope so. Obviously, we hope to bat the majority of the day tomorrow. Hopefully, the pitch will take spin later on in the game, and our two spinners can get in the match.
Michael, thank you very much, and well played.
Thank you.
Michael Atherton, justifiably happy at the way things went today after winning the toss. A very, very good toss to win, and England have finished up in a good position. And now, with his ideas on the overall picture of the day, here's Geoffrey Boycott.
Well, for two sessions, it was all England. They took full advantage of a very placid, easy-paced pitch. No pace, no bounce. First time for 17 test matches that the openers for England had given them a really good, solid start. I thought Michael Atherton in particular played really well. He looked comfortable against the spinners and the seam. In fact, I counted only twice did he play foolish shots. Nick Knight, well, he was slow and careful at the other end, and he was a good foil. England were in great position at tee, and then they lost it a bit. West Indies, through a lot of character, fought back, took wickets, and by the end of the day, England will feel, well, we're in control, but not as much as we'd like to have been. So tomorrow, with the new ball available, they've still got a bit of work to do, and West Indies could get back into the game.
Thanks very much, Geoffrey. Geoffrey Boycott with his ideas on what happened today and what might be coming up tomorrow. Well, I think it was a good day's cricket. It was slow, but an excellent stand between Knight and Atherton got England away. The century from the England captain, following on the win at Old Trafford, that will make everyone happy in the England supporters section. And the way the game finished up, we could be in for another very, very good game of cricket. We'll be on air tomorrow, and the details of that are BBC One, 10:55 a.m. That's the second day of this fifth Cornhill Insurance Test match. For a moment, from Trent Bridge, it's goodbye.
To be.